Senorita Nina from Argentina, you know all the answers. Although her relatives and friends are perfect dancers, she swore she'd never dance a step after she died. She said, I've seen too many movies, and all the proof is too idiotic. They all insist that South America's exotic. What if it couldn't be more boring if it tried? She firmly added that she hated what Santa Sotskit has, the sadder still lagoon. She also positively stated that she could not abide a southern moon. She said, I'd hate to be pathetic, but it drives me nearly frantic when I see that unromantic, syncopantic lot of sluts forever wrinkling their guts. It drives me absolutely nuts. She refused to begin the beginning when they requested it. And she made an embarrassing scene if anyone suggested it. For she detested it, so no one ever could be keener than little Nina on quite a number of very eligible men who did the rumba. When they proposed to her, she simply left the flat. She said that love should be impulsive, but not convulsive, and syncopation had the discouraging effect on procreation, and that she'd rather read a book, and that was that. She refused to begin the beginning when they besought her to, and in language profane and obscene she cursed the man who taught her to. She cursed Cole, taught her to. From this is fairly clear that Nina, in her demeanor, was so offensive that when the hatred of her friends was too intensive, she thought she'd better beat it while she had the chance. After some trials and tribulations, she reached a station and met a sailor who had acquired a wooden leg in Venezuela. And so she married him because he couldn't dance. Surely there never could have been a more irritating girl than Nina. Don't ever speak in Argentina of this degenerate bambina who had the luck to find romance but resolutely wouldn't dance.